Gaming, newly rebranded, unifying with Envy, becoming this formidable force, and it truly is a battle of titans here as map one CTF will take place on Aquarius, and we're right into the action, baby. Oh man, this is exciting.
Both these teams just playing it so carefully right off the bat, and look at that. Almost like a mirror image from both these players, both Snakebite and Trippy, pushing from util, putting in a few shots, just backing down, showing each other respect at the beginning engagements of this game.
Camel's gonna get picked up by APG, but immediately dropped there instantaneously, and that's gonna be Formal who ends up getting the better of that. And this has to be a really interesting matchup here for Formal, because he's still very much a part of Optic Gaming, but he could not pass up the opportunity to team with this Sentinels lineup. But man, oh man, the player that's on my mind that I wanna see perform here is Lucid. He has been the talk of the town since the release of the game, and so far he has not disappointed. But look at the Wizard Pistola. Unfortunately for him, it's gonna be Snakebite who gets the better of him there.
And it's so difficult. Even when you get someone down a couple shots in this game, these players' teamworks are so good that one just rounds the corner and they melt you so quick. You saw Ola even trying to run for his life, and Ola's just notorious for always getting away when he wants to. For him just get melted in a scenario like that just shows how on point the Sentinels teamwork is.
Every kill, every engagement between these teams is gonna come with tension, with drama. Frosty, though, one of the best players in the game, looking for an opportunity, but he's gonna get dropped right there. Now it's Lucid. Let's see what he could do here, as he's also dealing with a fair amount of fire from up top. As Lucid wraps around here, and as far as the scoreboard goes, you know, nothing really from Formal thus far. He's been silent. He's rocking a donut at the part of at the beginning of this game, but that's perfectly fine given how the action has unfolded here. Lucid pushes forward, and he does manage to get the kill, but gets absolutely blown up courtesy of Formal. That's his first.
Yeah, look at that scoreline. Lucid has 6 kills. The other teammates that he has right now, also 6 kills total. Lucid already just leading the pack around this. You saw his calm demeanor in that interview. He's saying, yes, I acknowledge and I think I'm the best player in this game. There's other great players out there, and I want that strong competition just because I think it makes it more exciting. But Lucid, you just saw that pure confidence he has. He is, without a doubt, one of the best players in Halo Infinite, if not the best player individually at the moment in this game.
I mean, we recall back in H5 when everyone kept saying the same thing about Frosty. The man was a trendsetter with his movement, with his playstyle, everything that he did, everyone emulated. And look at this here, no HP, no health, no shields, nothing, and he's still effective. Maybe looking for another one, but no, it's actually gonna be Trippy who's gonna stop him there right in his tracks.
And this game has just been so even. We have not seen either team really get all 4 down. We've seen a little bit of scattering of players where we have some at the opposing bases in a position to maybe grab a flag, but no real attempts at this moment in time.
Well, here comes number one, asking you shall receive, Walsh, because Snakebite's gonna start the move. The captain bringing it over to the right side of the map here. Formal needs to stop the player. It's gonna be Lucid, but Formal can't do it. Lucid's there for the stop, and that's a big, big win there for Lucid, as the flag is gonna be down right underneath Lucid. That is basically gonna be a good opportunity for them to bring that one right back to their base.
Look at that awareness too. Lucid just realizing that, all right, there's still somebody slipped through on our side. I'm not just gonna dive this flag and be cautious where it's at. Yeah, a counter cap. Well, that's all been going down, GB. We have Ola and the Optic Gaming squad trying to bring this first flag, and that's gonna be the first flag on the board for Optic Gaming.
Optic Gaming draw first blood here in this highly contentious matchup here against Sentinels. And it's gonna be courtesy of the Wizard Pistola. Another big win there as he drops Frosty. And now things slow down just a touch here. Respawn's coming in for Sentinels. Let's see what they're gonna be picking up here.
There's always just that little calm before the storm, Golden Boy.
Oh,
there's
these
moments in time where the pace, you know, slows down for a moment, or players get their shields, repositioning, or waiting for respawns, and then it all just goes into a flurry of action as it's just trade after trade of damage.
Well, Optic Gaming gonna keep the good times rolling here. They got the flag in hand, and they're gonna be bringing this across to the halfway mark here on Aquarius, but he's waiting. He's waiting to see if anyone's gonna pop up from behind. And look at the help that Lucid got there. Exactly what you want to see if you're going to start this flag run. Trippy, though, popped on the right side, and also a camo pickup here for Pistola. This flag should start to make its way across, but Ola's going to be playing the information game here, Walsh.
Yeah, they're down in numbers right now. Ola's just essentially looking to pick off a kill or two, and there's 4 perfect shots going in to Lethal to take him out. But kills traded back and forth, but that's an okay scenario for Optic Gaming. If you have the flag on your half of the map, like I said before, and you're trading kills, in theory, you're going to get that flag cap. Reinforcements are going to come out faster.
Yeah. While all that was going on, though, there was an attempted return, and it was successful by Sentinel. So we're back to the drawing board here as Lethal, who has had quite the career all throughout his time in Halo. He's been so prolific, constantly at the top, never outside of the top three. This guy has had quite the run. But of course, he's going to need to dig deep here. They're going to want to beat Optic Gaming, especially when Pistola is doing stuff like that. Lethal, though, is going to be pulling this flag to the left side, and he will be meeting Pistola in a moment's notice, and that's going to be an easy, easy kill for him.
I love that position by Ola. Ola's not panicking to drop down to recover that flag. Ola's just going to keep the high ground here on top car and slay a couple members of Sentinels.
Flag's back at base here. As Formal now. What are we expecting out of the replacement coming in for World 2 with Formal? A lot of people regard him as also one of the top 10 players in the game, so Sentinels getting Formal was a huge, massive pickup. And of course, a legend in his own right, a champion, a world champion in Call of Duty, very successful, starting his career in Halo 2. Pistola, though, not going to be good enough to be able to get the kill on that one. Snakebite on the prowl, does manage to find one with the heat wave. That's going to be a double kill there for the captain. Camo is available as well. And this is going to be grabbed now by APG, but I think that was burned right away.
I couldn't tell if it was burned or not. I'm sure the players will just double check, but yeah, it looked like it may have just clicked on for APG. So that's a big burn. You don't want to get that in the hands of Sentinels when you're off at your own side of the base.
Snakebite now looking to get some help. That's another double. Trippy, though, trying to get activated in this game. Does just that, stopping to push over at Yellow Utility. Here comes Frosty, though, in a 1v2. Not really going to help him out there. Trippy gets himself another one. And the Heat Wave has really been changing hands all throughout this match. It's such a powerful weapon to use. Does so much damage. You also get that lunge with the melee, too. Like, I've seen so many Heat Wave plays throughout this event. Like, it's 100% a weapon I'm going back and using. And I think everyone feels the same way as well. But Lucid doing the tried and true plays with the battle rifle, getting the job done. Another one down here as Formal is out of the equation. And here comes the push on the left side. Can Lucid win this battle? Yes, he does. The big one to keep the run going here for Optic.
That was an interesting scenario too, where Lucid went for the melee after one shot. I would have expected him to go two-shot melee there, but you know, who am I to question one of the current best players in Halo Infinite?
Well, here comes another flag pull for APG. It's going over to the left side here, out through utility, waiting for the nades to come through if they are. And there they are. They start to make some connections, but now APG, across the map we go. Snakebite knows that APG has his flag. There's no real opportunity for them to stop it, and that should be a clean capture and number two for the Green Wall.
Green Wall just looking so strong, and Trippy just being so sneaky, realizing that, all right, we haven't seen someone for a moment. He just hid over in utility, got a free kill on Snakebite, and that can't be understated. It's not just a kill on a strong player on Sentinels. I mean, they're all strong players, but it's a kill on their furthest player up. That now narrows down the angles that Optic Gaming has to check as they're pushing across the map. They realize that they killed the person furthest up. They can now focus all their firepower forward and towards the Sentinel base.
We'll see if they play with these advantages that they now have. Two up, 3 minutes and 38 seconds left on the clock. Camo as well here for APG. He's gaining a decent amount of information here as his teammates continue to get more kills. A nade is going to connect, but no indicators obviously here in Infinite. So no one's going to know that he's still going to be lingering about here. And that is going to be a flag to just draw the attention away and bring Sentinels back and make them fear Optic a little bit.
Yeah, what APG was actually looking for there is he was looking for one kill before he moved that across the map. He saw in the kill feed that Formal got a kill. He's not going to just pull that flag immediately and give away his position. So the second they had to start shooting across the map at Lethal and give away his spot, he said, all right, while my position's already given away, I'm going to toss this out into the bottom side of the map in case there's a flurry of exchanges and we get more kills than them and we can run this flag. But it's just more of like a safety measure. It's like, all right, my spot's busted. I'm not going to really be able to get away guaranteed in this position. But ideally, APG was looking to get a kill and then an immediate flag pull and move that across the map.
Well, if you're keeping your eyes here in the action, right, you're seeing a lot of blue beginning to push into the Optic Gaming base. This is where Optic's going to have to show their grit and their defense now. As Trippy and Lucid, I believe, are going to be all the way back in the base trying to protect it. A big win, and that's actually going to be a trade out there. Lethal all up in the face here of Optic Gaming, trying to close out this kill, and he's getting flanked on the left side too. So a good attempt there by Lethal, but the defense from Optic Gaming has been superb, and I honestly don't know what Sentinels have to do to break down this wall.
Yeah, it's really difficult because there have been many times where Sentinel gets a lot of kills. They're able to push across the map, but once they get towards the base, they're just not able to get that little extra ground that they need. They're not able to get that flagpole. They're not able to get it far enough across the map safely. So it just feels like either Optic Gaming are doing a great job of hunkering in their base, winning those important pivotal fights before the flagpole happens, or they're letting that flagpole happen without giving up all the kills, and they're able to scatter across the map. And that's where you've seen the times where Lucid's dropping in from top car, or you see Trippy flanking over at bottom pink. It's just been really difficult knowing how to fully lock down all these players from Optic Gaming.
And even when Sentinels have a little bit of an advantage, we just saw them a little while ago pick up the camo, and Optic immediately turned their attention. They knew they had to get rid of that player, and they did just that. So every moment that Sentinels have to get a breather, maybe this is going to be the opportunity that they could use, right? Frosty gets a double. We've seen this song and dance happen before, but there's nothing that they could do to capitalize off of the advantages that they have earned here, and that is just a credit to the defense of Optic Gaming. And look at Lucid, all the confidence in the world, because he knew he had Frosty dead to rights. This is where we're going to have to start to see some real grit out of Sentinels and how they're going to pull themselves out of this, because they don't have a lot of time remaining, Walsh. It's 50 seconds left on the clock.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of time remaining, and they're playing defense at the moment. They're just trying to do whatever they can to get these kills.
Big win by Trippy, keeping the drive alive here at Yellow Utility. So he pushes forward, scouting the land, seeing where people are. He lost two teammates, so that has to tell you that there is going to be a push here, but it's only going to be one player. And that's Snakebite. He gets neutralized, and that's it.
That's the second time we've seen that this game thus far, where Snakebite is the furthest player up, and Optic have done a good job of identifying which area is vulnerable on their side of the map, and they're able to pick them up over at their fridge or over at their utility. And that is the most integral kill, if I can be honest here, because that now, like I said, eliminates you from having to check your back. It eliminates that threat of immediate flagpole. It just does so many things for your squad. So the fact that Optic have been able to clear that out consistently and get this first game, Optic Gaming going up 1-0
real fast. So you are going to see players just kind of changing sides back and forth, because that's the nature of an arena FPS like Halo Infinite here. But we are on board with Formal, a world champion in his own right. He has accomplished so much. But to come back here after being away from Halo for such a long time and team with one of the best teams, arguably, the best team in a generation in Sentinels, right? Have that opportunity, man, that's some cool stuff. Yeah.
No, it doesn't seem like he's missed a step either. His aim is just on point. His positioning, he understands the different challenges he can make in Halo, so he's just on another level. But right off the bat, we saw during this game, Lucid was able to slide right in and grab those rockets. So we did see an absolutely aggressive play coming out from Optic, just using the Lucid movement that he has.
I really like how Pistola, he's kind of biding his time over here, and that's why Frosty's just flying at him, but he had the help from Lucid, so you trade that out right away, and now Optic Gaming are going to go up by 4 at the early part of this game here. Let's see, though, what Formal and the rest of Sentinels can cook up, because they're going to need to do something or else this game can get out of hand.
And if I'm certain, it feels like Formal's just kind of chilled over here towards top seed this entire game. Maybe they want to have this sort of anchor position, where Formal just kind of sits up towards the top balcony using his strong, steady shot to just lay on damage across the map over towards B Street, over towards Purple, over towards bottom middle. But it seems like Formal has been very stagnant and almost like I said, an anchor position here.
Trippy does have the help. Top of the ledge, he's going to go in there with the assault rifle. Decent amount of damage, and he should be getting some assistance here in a moment, but he's not going to need it. Takes out Snakebite with relative ease, courtesy with the help that he got from the assault rifle. And yeah, I mean, Formal has basically been living here the whole time, and Trippy gets a back
play.
That's huge. You had to consider that Trippy was still going to be around there, but because Formal didn't have vision on mid, there was nowhere that they could call that Trippy was going to be making the push happen here.
Yeah, and that's one of the difficult parts. As soon as you lose someone in the center of this map, you're not sure which way they're going to go, especially with someone as fast as Trippy or Lucid.
True.
But I actually want to hear how we're seeing it from the Sentinels' point of view. So we're going to go to Astro Listen with Sentinels right now.
Okay. 1 second. 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 1 second Matt, I'm here. I'm on about.
Okay, okay, we can.
Trippy's weak, Toppy's weak. Toppy's
weak, guys.
Toppy's weak, Toppy's weak.
Front C, ABG.
Arcade Ola, Arcade Ola.
One shot.
One shot. Trippy's reset.
Yo, B-step, B-step, Trippy, one shot.
Ola half health arcade.
Ola's one shot, Ola's one shot.
Shot is coming up.
Push the seal, push the seal.
I got him.
B-step, B-step, Trippy.
B-step,
one C-step, B-step, B-step, B-step. And two
C-steps. Lucid's one shot. And ABG, and one's mid map.
Yeah,
watch tires with the
tires.
Went mid map, Yeah. Careful, Matt. Careful.
Yeah, he's pushing.
Watch your left. I gave him a
left.
Okay.
PG,
let's fight this. Matt, I gave you a left. I'm coming.
I have shoddy, bro.
Watch APG.
Yo, Ola's flowers.
Oh, tires, trippy.
PJ, I'm pushing this.
Hold on, help me.
Another one,
yeah, go, Brad, go.
B-stairs,
one's on my back, one's on my back.
You know where, bro?
B-stairs. Yeah. Okay, guys, let's just slow down. Try to listen, alright?
Yeah.
This guy driveway, or not?
I can help you.
Shotgun. Yeah, shotgun.
It was Lucid. He has
shotgun. Shotgun going top C. Shotgun going top C.
He's in our table. Stock.
No, I think we need to kill the guy left. I think we have to just go left.
I'm pushing real quick.
Yeah, you're good, bro. You're good. All right, let's go left.
Guys. Left. Kill Trippy.
Flowers.
Watch out, Trippy. Absolutely. Another close. Flowers. Nice. Good job. Shot two. Yep.
Top C with Bulldog, ABD, Michael driveway.
Yeah, yo, benches weak.
Yo, back up rockets. Driveway, TH, help me.
They're hard.
Trippy, one shot.
An absolutely stellar listen in there with Sentinels. Yes, they are down in this, but it's just about the small talk, the way that they're communicating with one another. The problem is that Optic Gaming, they're giving them no openings to work with. And you're hearing some moments where like, I'm just going to go ahead and push this guy left because I have to take care of him. Moment that happens, a Sentinel beam comes out and there's not much you can really do there.
That's where these teams are starting to solve and figure each other out as these games go on. That's why there's many times you'll see a top team playing, like, let's say, an 8 through 16 team, and they're losing up until around the 30 kill mark, and they seem to find that little crack in the strategy saying, oh, actually, if we take out this person on the left side, we have all this room to roam around and make plays. And that's exactly what Sentinels are trying to do, but they didn't see a little pistola near the flowers with the Sentinel beam.
And look at this here. Another thing to note, folks, is that Sentinels have basically lived on the police station side of the map here on streets the entire time. Optic Gaming have not allowed them to be able to get out of this position. And we talked ahead of time and said, yeah, probably on this map, you're going to see these teams like changing sides, flying at one another. That's not happening. Optic have contained Sentinels and have only continued to add on to this lead 26-17. It's growing for Optic, and that's dangerous for Sentinels.
Yeah, that's dangerous. And I wonder if that's a couple factors. One is Optic just knows how to play streets a lot better than you would expect through most other Slayer matches. The second one is these players from Sentinels just being in such strong positions. Because if you get a couple kills and someone like Formal's over at the C balcony, you don't really have a good, quick way to concisely like break down and like collapse in on that player. Yeah. There's just no fast route to it. You either have to get some sort of lucky grenade or both of you hope that Formal overextends and you can get that pick. So I think that's been the difficulty as far as collapsing through it. Here's one of the few times we're actually seen the Optic roster break on through the Sentinels defense. That's Ola slipping behind over at the C tower.
Yeah, and you just cannot let that happen. And obviously it's going to be easier said than done, right? I mean, we're talking about Pistola, a guy who finds a way to stay alive in literally any possible gunfight that he engages himself in. But we're starting to see some help come in here. And the thing to note as well is that Sentinels, right, the score is 34-23, but they're still playing like it's like a 23-23 or 34-34 game. And they got rockets again. This is another time that Sentinels have been able to gain control. Control the power weapons, but still Optic hold on firmly to this lead.
Also, super minor thing you notice Form will do right there. If you're new to playing here on Infinite, if you grab the rockets immediately and you YY, switching weapons to your battle rifle and switching back to the rockets, you can shoot that rocket just a slight bit faster. So if you're ever getting yourself in those positions where you're picking up rockets and you're not killing someone immediately off the rack, do a quick YY and you can shoot that rocket, like I said, about a half second faster.
Pro tips with Walshy here on the main stage. And,
I should have said this after the big team battle match. Now if you kill the Rockets a little bit faster, I'm gonna be livid.
Yeah, I'll try it. But right now I wanna see Sentinels try and bring this game back here. I mean, they're down by 11. It is a substantial lead that Optic Gaming have here, and Sentinels, they can't quite crack this egg. They have a player over in Arcade. They have another one all the way yonder on the ramp, and one more on the steps too. They know exactly where everyone is, but they just don't have the angles.
And they're still trying to execute that same strategy. You heard before Sentinels, when we went to the Astro listening, how they want to try to take over this left side over on the B stronghold, but they just have not been able to break through.
It's been so difficult for Sentinels, but if you're Optic Gaming, this is some high-quality expert Halo that we're seeing being played by them. They're putting on a clinic here. Beautiful shots from Lucid. Got a little dicey there with that spike grenade, but he's going to be all right. And here goes that Stalker rifle, man. That thing is vicious weapon.
My Master Chief does not move like that, Golden Boy.
No, it doesn't.
I don't know how his moves like that.
My moves like it has a wheelchair, so I don't know how Lucid does it.
One of the old Halo 1 guys, Prayfer, used to say, I have a fat Master Chief or something, and his just did not move as quick as something like Lucid. But look at this. They're just running away with this. This is a 12-kill lead here for Optic Gaming, almost certain to close this one out shortly.
Good reads there by Lucid. Should be able to take out Frosty here if someone's going to be around to receive him. 46-35. A miracle is going to have to happen here for Sentinels, and maybe that miracle can come in the boomstick with the rockets. What can they do? They just lost Lethal. Three more frags left for Optic Gaming. Finding one low. No kill confirmed quite yet. A massive spike, but no one's there to stop him. On the opposite side of that here, you can see a player starting to push up on ramps. That's going to be Lucid. He's going to dial back over to Tramp. Frosty has no choice but to go help out his teammate here. It's the last death here. And, oh, I stand corrected. That was the second to last death. But they're just going to go and collapse with the Bulldog for the dub all on form. Don't get me wrong. It's just, you know, like, you see a name like that, you kind of want to see some heavy slaying come through. But I totally agree with you, Dave, that this is a Halo's a team sport at the end of the day. Yeah. You have to perform. You have to show up. And right now, Optic Gaming are doing just that as we jump into our third game. And for Optic, maybe their potential final game in this series against Sentinels. It's Live Fire Oddball.
And once again, we do see Formal in an anchor position over towards the top C tower. So it just seems to be a common theme we have with Formal here on this roster, really kind of coming into mold and fitting in to that Royal 2-esque anchor role.
Oh boy, and Frosty was trying to get a little cheeky on the outside there. Unfortunately for him, it didn't really work out. Right over here by Dummies for a Pistola. Ball's been grabbed by Formal. They also have Overshield, they got Sniper. They have everything. They also have the kitchen sink as well. Maybe they'll throw it at them if they're feeling a little cheeky, but see what they could do with this here. Is Lucid now. See Snakebite, and they're actually, I gotta give them credit. Besides that there, they were trying to stay away from the crosshairs of Lucid as much as they could. Unfortunately, just didn't work out there.
Well, there's just such a great rotation from Sentinels there, moving that over towards B, but during that entire time, none of the Optic Gaming members were really panicking. None were trying to just get their own sort of flank and go towards B pillars. None were just trying to run over towards B nest and do anything on their own. They all were moving as a unit. So you just saw Optic just collapse over and over. They took up every little bit of ground that was given to them by Sentinels and just collapsed in and were able to pick up three members and got the slay advantage.
Trippy with the Mangler. Looking to stop the ball carrier, which is going to be Frosty currently the lead here for Sentinels. Two players located out toward B on the left side. You also have two behind, but there goes Pistola popping up. Oh, never mind. I was going to say, there goes Pistola. And yeah, there he is. He manages to get himself a kill. Pops up right behind him like magic. And now this is where Optic start to add some more points there in their favor.
Yeah, in a position that was originally strong. Ooh. A great pickoff from Formal to take out Ola right there. But what I was going to highlight was they were rotating that ball over towards B, and originally what was a good spot for Lethal and Formal to support in turned out to be a detrimental spot. You don't really want to be spawning out there at B when the opposing team has the ball over at A or C.
Yeah, it's an uphill battle, both figuratively and literally, especially on live fire. See what Trippy could do here with the Mangler. He knows that there's going to be some players pushing around here toward the OS spawn. Big win.
Did you also notice what he did there with the Mangler? If you drop the Mangler rather than hitting swap weapon, you get your BR shot a little bit faster. So you notice there after he hit his second Mangler shot, he held down the swap weapon button, which enabled him to drop it and just shooting, like I said, like 0.1 or 0.25 seconds later. Watch the shy away video and you can find out exactly how much longer it takes. But that is just a different mechanic that these players are taking advantage of within this Halo Infinite sandbox.
Yeah, dropping weapons is a new thing that has been added here for Infinite, as well as the equipment that you see being played out. And yeah, I mean, there's so many little tools. Of course, a big shout out to Shyway over in the Bravo station with Tony as well. You can catch all the action throughout the weekend. We got games going on all over the place on Twitch and YouTube. Shout out to everyone who's been helping us break some records here today. But Back at the action at hand, though, Optic Gaming continue to add on to this lead. It was looking good for Sentinels in the beginning, but once Optic, you know, they get an inch, they take a mile.
Oh my god, not only does Trippy get that kill, Trippy runs away, lives, and gets a grenade on Snakebite.
Ridiculous.
That play cannot be understated how important that was to get the kill and stay alive. You saw how flustering that had to be for Snakebite, just assuming that, all right, we're going to pick off this person on plasmas and then go make our move.
But he still stays alive, and he's still going to be effective there, right? Like, that's a big win for Snakebite regardless, because he didn't take a fight that wasn't necessary, which just goes to show the 5D chess that these players are playing against one another. It is so impressive, the micro decisions that they all have to make, and maybe this is where Sentinels can start to add something on the leader, or excuse me, on the scoreboard here, and that's another thing. Snakebite shooting a shot off in the distance, take away as much of the ammo, and that was something I started to see, or we all started to see in H5 when you wanted to keep snipers away from Splice at the time. That was something Sen did a lot, and they also had that done to them. Just small details that are changing the difference between these two teams.
Yeah, and it's got to be difficult for me and the audience to hear Golden Boy talk about 5D chess from someone who can probably barely play checkers.
Oh, I'm so a terrible. I'm more of a Chinese checkers
spot that we'll go into strategy about later. But yeah, you bring up that great point that these players are very selective of what fights they're taking. They realize when they do have those minimal advantages, they really have to press those, get those finish kills while they can, and then they can collapse in together. So it's one of those situations that, like I said, the fact that Trippy was able to stay alive so long, it really changed the tides of that battle.
Yeah, well, they're trying to clear out bottom mid, and that's Trippy with that heat wave. Pistola can't go in there and help out quite yet. Has to wait for the shields to come back to the Pulsar as well. Big win there for Formal, but APG's there to help out his teammate immediately after that. The lead continues to add up here for Optic Gaming, 70-32. Sentinels have not had an opportunity to get the ball and get time on there. Finally, they grab the ball, and finally, they could maybe cross that 40-point threshold.
But they're really not getting any sort of solid setup. They're not getting like
a full setup
at a tower or towards garage or anything. They're scrapping up a little bit of time as they're trying to rotate it away and get away from the Optic Gaming members.
Oh, good challenge. Lethal with a big win there against APG. For the Repulsor as well to send him back. That actually was a pretty smart play there. Unfortunately, didn't really work out the way that he would have liked to, but he did everything he could with the sandbox and the tools that he had available at his disposal. Ball's still going to be available bottom mid, and this works out in the favor here of Optic Gaming because they can let this thing keep going. It's Oddball's a round-based game now, Walsh. You can let them continue to make the push low. They don't got to grab the ball. They got the lead.
Yeah, when you're in the lead like that, you are fine with just trading kills. So as long as Optic does not panic and does not let Sentinels get a full setup or control, they don't really have to worry about them making this massive 30-point run. They want to make Sentinels sacrifice one of their lives to get 3 or 5 seconds. And yeah, in doing so, they lose the control. It's just sort of like that crazy catch-22. Like, how do we get points if we don't get control? All right, how do we get control if we don't get kills?
And yeah,
all those sort of situations. So it's a really difficult spot for Sentinels to be in as they are seemingly forced to grab some ball time or get a rotation while getting the kills on Optic, who are such strong slayers.
Well, it works out for them here. They do manage to get that ball time. Formal also gets himself the overshield. It's going to get aggressive there onto Pistola, but handled just like that. Sniper Rifle will be available bottom pillars, and Crossy's looking for the movement. Where is he going to go here? The Repulsor up above. A great play there, too. I mean, really just taking advantage of all the equipment available, and he had to anticipate
that
was going
to
come.
Look at the score. They were able to tie it up during those scrappy times, so hats off to Sentinels as they did such a fantastic job trading slays and grabbing time throughout that. Optic are going to have to get some sort of response here. I don't know if they're going to try to go for some sort of full setup or if they're going to scrap some time, but this is very interesting how Sentinels are taking advantage of all these scrappy times while they're able to trade kills. So I really don't know how they're able to do that against the likes of Optic.
I wonder what the intention was there, because you know the Oddball does slide a fair amount when you drop it, unlike previous Halos. Like, it's got some movement to it, so one has to wonder if Lethal wanted to bring that back around. But the good news for them, though, is that all of it works out because they do have possession of the ball, and it is going to continue to tick in their favor. Formal, we wanted him to come online. We wanted him to be a difference maker. I think it's safe to say he's definitely found his stride here here on live fire as he's going to go and help out Frosty, just dying there. Trippy now locating where the ball is, but as he comes out of bottom mid, they knew exactly where he was, anticipated it, and it feels like Sentinels are starting to click here. Only 3 points remaining, but they're going to have to slum it out in bottom mid to try and get control of the ball because APG has it in his hands.
There is actually a decent shot right here for Optic to get a Garage step. You see Trippy escorting their player over towards Garage. They're picking up Formal out here near the training dummies. This is just a brawl here at the very end. All these players scrambling for it. That's three dead for Sentinels, and Optic have a Garage setup.
Yeah, they have to fly right now. Your eyes do not deceive you. Yes, there are 3 seconds left on the clock, but the time freezes when you have the ball in your hand in the new oddball in Halo Infinite. 5 seconds remaining here. They have to fly at them here. Optic have to stop this. They have to stop the push, but it's going to be Optic Gaming who clutch up when they needed it and win the first round here on Oddball Live Fire.
Oh my God, I love that new oddball mechanic where when you grab the oddball, time just freezes. So we are allowed to see comebacks like that. And just like that, we're already in round two. We can't even reflect
on the last
round.
No time to bring it down, Walsh. No time. We'll leave it to the desk. We'll handle it later. There's action to cast here on the main stage. But hey, Sentinels, I think this is where they're starting to find their rhythm. And I think that for Sentinels, if they keep the pace going like this, keep going at Optic. Don't give them that time. Don't give them that moment to breathe, right? Like you saw on Street Slayer. This could very well be the time where they turn it around because Optic had to scrap for that win and they just pulled it off by the skin of their teeth.
Yeah, and you saw Lethal. Wow, I can't believe he actually snagged that OS. I was gonna say, it looked like he jumped up for the OS and barely missed it, but knowing the radius of grabbing equipment like that, he just touched his toe on the top there at that platform, grabbed the OS and activated it right from behind. So
okay.
Great job by Lethal to acquire that. But also, don't be deceived if you're just joining in on this match. It is actually 1-0 for Optic here on Oddball. So if Sentinels are somehow able to take this round, we're going to see you at round three.
That's right. A little glitch in the spectator there. But don't worry, we'll keep reminding you throughout in case you need it. I'm sure folks in the chat will do the same thing as well. In the early parts of this game, though, overshield grab, heat wave grab for Sentinels, but no real time gained. And now it's going to be Optic in control as they brought this ball over to Garage, and they're going to try and hold off this attack from Sent.
And Lucid getting a very crucial kill on Frosty to start the defense of this push here. Oh my God! We saw Ola running away to Trippy, like, come on, help me, buddy. Someone like Ola, to buy time like that is so valuable for a roster. It just gives those split seconds where one of the teammates can just start getting VR shots on them, or, you know, if you're Trippy, you just no-scope them across the map.
Indeed, and that's going to be an easy one as well. Player was weakened, body shot. Frosty knew that that was basically going to be a wrap there. Trippy, though, trying to stay alive in mid, not going to happen. They got to go after this ball. Good rotation as well. If you recall, they had that ball over in Garage, and they started to make moves to bring it over to Tower. We also have Overshield available, too. Formal has a teammate there, and that was a smart play to make. Also, a repulsor to try and maybe send the nades back, or was a misstep. But, of course, we'll have to see how this plays out. They have OS.
Yeah, that was more of a slight misstep from Formal and the Sentinels roster, because since Formal was already kind of pushed up over there near Plasmas, and this is such a small, nuanceable difference, but Formal did not want to go back in territory, did not want to head back to grab that OS, wanted to rely on a teammate that's already near scoreboard to jump up and get that. And once Formal saw his teammate there, he allowed for that to happen, but just a slight misstep. And unfortunately, that can be the difference maker here in Halo Infinite.
Well, you also hate to see a player just falling off of the map there. Shout out to Clayster. I hope you're watching, buddy. but now we start to see Sentinels add some time here to the clock. He'll never be able to get away from that, by the way. A good play ball, and again, for the newer viewers, right, play ball, you toss it off the map so that this way it respawns back in the middle. It's going to force all the attention and reposition everyone as well, but seems like Optic are going to be able to gain this ball. Remember, guys, Optic won that last round, so now the onus is going to be on Sentinels to have to push this, or else it's going to be game over, and Sentinels will lose in a 3-0 sweep.
Yeah, and this is such a difficult spot. There's two members down for Sentinels. When the ball is over here towards bottom A as well, towards this tower,
gotta fly.
There's really not much you can do. Looks like Snakebite's able to get that stop, but not only do they need to get the stop, they need to follow this up with a long step of their own. So the I guess, silver lining here in this position is that Sentinels have a good setup. The bad news is you have to hold this for 60 seconds straight. Just to tie this game up.
You literally cannot give anything up here. And Snakebite needs to recognize, when am I going to have to drop this ball so I can help out my teammates? He's getting pushed from the side and plays the ball, but are they in a position to grab it?
There's four dead, though. There's four dead from Sentinel, so there's really not, like, a great advantage of getting a play ball in some of these scenarios when the opposing team's only 5 seconds away from scoring.
Lethal's going to try and make a play here in bottom mid. He's got no one there to help him out. They do manage to grab the ball. No one has died quite yet, though. Lethal takes a shot. Frosty goes down. Ball's still going to be available here to pick up. No one on the Sentinel side is around to go and pick it up. Pistola has obtained it. Only a few seconds remaining, but here comes the push from Formal. He's not going to be able to stop him. And with only a few seconds remaining, it's going to be Optic Gaming with a 3-0 sweep over the Sentinels here in Winners Round 2 at HGS Raleigh.
What a heated match. I mean, we expected them to go back and forth, but Optic just showing that they are currently the better team right here on land, 3-0 in Sentinels.
What a series for Optic Gaming. A statement has been made here. As they know that at this point in time, Optic Gaming, they are one of the teams to beat coming into this competition. Sentinels are as well, but they're not going to have to go back to the drawing board while